Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I am really excited. I am launching a brand new series based on loads and loads of questions and on a number of clients coming to me with a specific issue. And that issue is our sexuality and our libido. So this series is going to be a monumental series. I've actually got a list of different topics I'm going to cover. So I'm going to pick up my notes and actually share that with you. This video is about introducing the series, explaining some of the reasons why our sexuality and our libido has taken a bit of a nosedive, why we're struggling to feel sexy, while we're struggling to reach a climax, while we're struggling to actually connect with ourselves and with our partners. So if you feel like you're not very sexy, if you're struggling with low energy, low libido, you want to have sex because you love your partner, but you're just struggling to get your head in the right place, to feel the energy to do it. And of course, that creates this negative cycle. So the more that you don't do it, the more you keep getting excuses, and negative cycle gets in the way, that feeling guilty about having sex again. So the number of sexual opportunities decreases and you feel worse and worse about yourself. So if you feel like you're lacking a sex drive, whether it's because you're just struggling with how you feel physically, how you feel emotionally, if it's your hormones, whether you're going through premenstrual tension or perimenopause or menopause itself, all of these things can upset our libido. The 21st century is a huge upsetter of our libido and our physicality. And with COVID, which we're still going through, the lockdown changed the way we lived, changed the way we saw ourselves. And all of those things have had a dramatic effect on our lives, and in particular our sex life, because we've been forced to spend too much closeted time with people. We're not able to go out and connect with other friends. A lot of pressure is put on our other half, and that also brings into play all sorts of triggers which prevent us, barriers that get in the way of our sexuality. So whether you're on your own and you just want to explore your sexuality, whether you're with a long-term partner and your sexuality is on the decline, or whether you just want to find a new partner from a happier place of sexual connection and ease, this next series is for you. So thank you to all those people who have shared some fascinating questions. So stay to the end of this video. It is an introductory video, but I do want to share one simple supernatural energy medicine technique that will instantly relax you and will ignite your own sensuality. So this is something you can do every day for 5 or 10 minutes ahead of the time when you're thinking you might want to have sex or to be sexual. If you're not going to be sexual, it's still a lovely thing to do for yourself. So instant relaxation, instant let go of physical tension, instantly getting out of your head and into the sensual parts of your body. So that's at the end of the video, but I'm now going to pick up my notes and tell you some of the exciting things that we've got coming in this series. So I'm taking two approaches. With energy work, there are always many ways to go about a singular issue. One of those ways is to get rid of the barriers. And the other way is to work on the things that you want to have, you'd love to have, the positives. So one is acts the negatives, and the other is work with the positives. It's common sense. So the things that are barriers that are getting in the way are things like our stress levels, living on high adrenal alert, living in fight, flight, freeze. As soon as that fight, flight, freeze is turned on, our sexuality, like many other non-vital functions, is turned off. So we need to de-stress. We need to have more energy. So if you've got low energy, you're feeling like you can barely drag yourself out of bed, of course, the last thing you want to do is expend more energy having sex. So what can we do about low energy? And one of the things that relates to that is poor sleep. So again, if you're not getting sleep, perhaps because you're high on adrenaline and you get that boost just before you go to bed, and then you're in your head and you've got circling thoughts, sleep is so important to restoring your body at a cellular level and giving you back your sexuality and your libido. Nourishment. And nourishment is more than just food. So I want to talk about adaptogens, about essential oils, and I do want to talk about some food types that you should definitely throw out the window if you want to have a higher sex drive, and ones that you need to eat more of. So what can you do with your physical body to really get it revved up to embrace your sexuality? Emotional blocks. Well, many women in particular, and now men, and to be fair, the difference between male and female sexuality is evening out as the changes in our society are starting to become more noticeable. So as many men as women are disempowered sexually. So what's going on up here? Many people have body dysmorphobia or body fear. They don't like their own bodies. They feel out of control with their own bodies, and they feel bad, negative guilt about sexuality, as opposed to feeling more of the natural feelings of it. This is part of being human. This is a natural part of being who I am, and embracing sexuality as being innocent, wonderful, a way of fulfilling your body's true potential. So let's talk about those emotional blocks as well. So then I want to come on to the positives, and I will mix and match. So whatever is floating your boat at the time, so whatever questions you have, what ideas you have, things you want to know more about, please send your comments, comment on the videos, comment on this video. Let me know what's getting in your way, and I can share some amazing natural techniques to shift your energy so that you can embrace your sexuality and boost your libido. So let's talk about the positives. So that's things like igniting your sexual energy. So if you feel like, you know, you're just going through the motions, you are having sex, but you're totally turned off during it, we need to be in igniting, revving up your sexual liberation, allowing your sexual connections to take place in your body so that you feel like you can climax, so you can feel that amazing cathartic release. We want to do some sexual meditation. So I've talked about your headspace being in the right place and not being on your shopping list or your to-do list or your worry list. So that we want to do some meditation to get you into that sensual place ahead of the game. And also some energy psychology. So some tapping that allows us to change our state, to shift our sexual gear, and to move into, let's think of an archetype. We're going to move into our Marilyn Monroe, our lover archetype, to feel more Marilyn, to feel more sexy. And we're going to do some tapping to shift us into that state. So there are so many things that we can do. This is at least a 10 video series. And there's probably many more as I go through this that tend to trigger more and more ideas. So please share your thoughts, share your ideas. But without further ado, I want to share an instant way of de-stressing and inviting your sensuality into your body. Now let's rub together our amazing electromagnetic and subtle energy tools, our hands, shake off any of that extra energy. What we're going to do is we need to have bare arms or bare legs for this. I'm going to show you on my arms because that's easier to film. But you can do this particularly over your joints. So your joints in energy medicine are where our energy gets stuck and stagnated. And to be in your sexual flow, to feel sensual, you need to have your energy flowing. So we're going to do some using your hands very, very gently, barely touching your skin, doing some gentle, rhythmic, slow figure eights. Breathing deeply through your nose. Smiling. Smiling is wonderful for sexual energy. And letting it go through your mouth. You can make those figure eights as big or as small as you like. You can just totally focus on the crease of your elbow. You can take it up the whole of your arm. whatever feels nice for you. Actually, it feels really nice for me today. And this is up to you to explore your own sensuality. But the scientific reason why this works is that we have 17,000 mechanoperceptors. So the things that allow us to sense our world through the sense of touch. We have 17,000 of these mechanoperceptors in our hands. So our hands are sensual tools. Remember to keep breathing, and I'm going to switch arms. You might want to shut your eyes, put on some slow music, your favorite romantic music. Oh. And you'll start to feel your skin is coming alive. And your body was designed to feel, to touch. And it's something that we don't tend to do. Even in the act of sex, we might often jump to the end game. We avoid the foreplay because there isn't the time. But believe you me, if you make the time to do this, do it for yourself, do it for your partner, do it for each other. But I would recommend doing it one at a time. Not both to each other simultaneously. This is something to relax and completely enjoy that feeling of your skin coming to life, those waves of warm sensuality moving through your body. I always like to imagine a color. Whatever color comes to mind for you is the color that you need. So think of what color will excite your sensuality. What color makes you feel warm, open and receptive? The color orange, apricots, soft, gentle tones are coming to me. I'm imagining as I do these figure eights, the color is coming like waves through my body, filling my whole body. And that's a beautiful, beautiful thing. So you experiment with your own mechanoperceptors, 17,000 in each hand, rubbing up the insides of your legs, the inside of your thighs is a really wonderful place as well. And you might also find the back of your neck are all wonderful, sensual, erogenous zones. They will de-stress and relax you. Your skin is like this amazing pressure valve. It's an energy valve, so that if you use that figure eight, you're allowing excess energy to dissipate, and instead you're building sensual energy. So how good is that? It's so, so simple. Do that, you know, every evening or every morning. Do it when you're in bed. Do it before your partner gets into bed. And I promise you, you'll feel instantly a lot sexier. So there you go. I hope you've enjoyed that little tip today. And do join, do comment. This is, I know it's a taboo subject, but this is a subject which so many people are struggling with right now. So please do share your thoughts, share your feedback, share your questions. And if you like this video, please join me for more. Subscribe so you don't miss all of this amazing new series. And if you like, then more and more people will see this through the YouTube algorithm. So thank you so much for listening, and join me for the ultimate natural guide to embrace your sexuality and boost your libido, change your energy, change your life, change your sex.